Isn't that magic? After 35 years, Formula One comes back to Zandvoort. Let's talk about magic tonight. The importance of magic, how we lose it so easily, and how we can get it back. No one believed that Formula One could ever return to Zandvoort again. Obvious, because the race circuit was massively outdated, it was way too small, with only limited possibilities to overtake. Not to mention the accessibility challenges of Zandvoort in general. And the beautiful nature surrounding the race circuit, which should be protected. So how come that today the Dutch Grand Prix is impossible to ignore? How come that as we speak now, Max Verstappen is testing Zandvoort, the complete renovated circuit? Obviously, because some people had seen the potential of it. And it's the magic of that dream that enlightens others to walk that extra mile, to make the impossible possible. Never before have I seen 300,000 tickets sell out so easily. Never before have I seen hundreds of companies purchasing large-scale VIP hospitality packages with a 3-year commitment. Never before have I seen sponsors expressing their support before any certainty could be given. So magic attracts. And if magic attracts us, we want to dream about it. We want to live it, and we want to pass it on. Dreaming about racing and race cars is what all kids do, don't they? At least, it's what I did when I was young. I played with stuff like that. But even as grown-ups, we all dream about being a hero, like Max Verstappen. Not to mention the countless people who want to win the acceleration sprint when the traffic lights turn green. Yes, they do. And we want to live the magic, as if we were really there. When I was previously interviewed by Carla Visser, she's part of the TEDx Haarlem team and she must be here in the audience, she showed up with a photo album, a beautiful old photo album which belonged to her father, full of pictures of her father together with the race legend Stirling Moss. She showed me the book, page after page. Not her book, her father's book. Not her pictures, her father's pictures. Carla was living the magic captured by the photos of her father, even when she wasn't there. That is what magic can do to people. Isn't that fantastic? So we want to dream about the magic. We want to live the magic, even if we're not there. And we want to pass it on. I can't tell you the number of stories I've heard of people and their memories of Formula One. Trips with their dads, talking about the good old days, and the joy they have today as they can now pass this experience on to their children. I took my son to Zandvoort when he turned 3 years. He liked it a lot, but I have to admit, maybe I liked it even more, because I was able to pass the magic of racing to my son. So from this, we can only conclude that everyone wants to connect with the magic of racing, wants to be part of it, and wants to embrace it. So how come, if we crave for that magic so hard, that we lose it, that we get stuck, and that we get lost so easily in our day-to-day life? Let me tell you what happened to me. In 1993, I started my first company, which I then sold in 1999. I was a millionaire just before I went 30. I invested all the proceeds in my dream. the first five-star eco resort in the Caribbean. Aqualibrium, where nature comes natural. 9/11 in 2001 put an end to this dream. I lost all my money and I had to start all over again. I came back to the Netherlands and started a new company. With heavy investment from the Telegraaf Media Group, I was back on top in 2006, ready to embark on a new dream. I wanted to buy a big house on the Keizersgracht in Amsterdam, big enough for the woman of my dreams and the two children we had. But then the bank crisis hit. Telegraaf withdrew, and all my savings were absorbed into the company. Another dream was broken, and I was broke again. So it was, again, back to the drawing table. After 20 years of being an entrepreneur, I had a new goal. I wanted a top position within a big company. I held executive positions at Telegraaf and Sky Radio Group, at Financieel Dagblad and BNR, and also at Talpa. Jobs to be proud of. However, after years of mergers and restructures, I found myself further away from the magic that I was looking for. I need a coach, so I got myself a coach. And this coach asked me, what do you want to achieve? And I told him, until my 30s, I felt like a compass. I was successful and I received a lot of recognition. I wanted even more. So that turned me into a radar. I scanned the outside world and I gave them what they were looking for. Recognition helped boost my ego, but it left a hole in my heart. Please, I want to go back to my compass, help me. He looked at me and he said, despite your big ego, your enormous ego, I can help you. I can bring you back to your compass. I can bring you back to your true self. But for that, you must be willing to let go the world around you. You must be willing to let go your friends. You must be willing to even let go your family. About a year later, my wife wanted a divorce. In a way, I had to let go my kids. I quit my job. I sold my house on the Keizersgracht, got rid of my car, and I adopted a minimalist lifestyle. And I took a sabbatical. I traded in city life for weeks of walking in the Alps with no other company than my own. So, while my assets were decreasing, my self-worth began to increase. By the end of 2018, I refound my compass, ready to embrace life again. It took me a long time to realize that there is still magic in all of us. However, most of us have lost that magic while chasing their goals, just like me. And it's about time that we set this magic free. What I learned is that we only need a little spark to ignite that magic, like Stirling Moss did to the father of Carla. A little spark that reminds us of our dreams. That's when I want to quote Steve Jobs. He said, "It's of the most importance that you follow your heart and intuition. Somehow they already know what you truly want to become." And I like to rephrase that in my own words. Ask yourself, is there still magic in your life? If you lost it, get it back. If you found it, share it. Together, we can get the magic back in this world.